It is beginning to look a lot like the residents out there. Got some snow down, albeit it's wet snow, but you do have some snow down. If you don't like it, no fears. It's supposed to rain on Friday. Maybe it'll wash it all away. Who knows? But for tonight, there is snow. Okay. Got some bells.
Come and behold him, born the King. funny, you know, because I know that at Christmas Eve, sometimes when I come, I don't have my family with me because they have their dad and other Vicky has her mother-in-law, father-in-law, they all have different places they have to be, so they're all not here on Christmas Eve. So this is so special to me because they're all here. And I think about my mum and dad and my grandparents and how they would have thought our mum was of their family. And I'm just so thankful. So the Annunciation to Mary, Luke 1:26-35. And in the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God unto a city of Galilee named Nazareth, to a virgin espoused to a man whose name was Joseph, of the house of David, and the virgin's name was Mary. And the angel came in unto her and said, Hail, thou that art highly favored, the Lord is with thee, blessed art thou among women. And when she saw him, she was troubled at his saying, and cast in her mind what manner of salutation this should be. And the angel said unto her, Fear not, Mary, for thou hast found favor with God. And behold, thou shalt conceive in thy womb, and bring forth a son, and shall call his name Jesus. He shall be great, and shall be called the Son of the Highest. And the Lord God shall give unto him the throne of his father David. And he shall reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there shall be no end. Then said Mary unto the angel, How shall this be, seeing I know not a man? And the angel answered and said unto her, The Holy Ghost shall come upon thee, and the power of the Highest shall overshadow thee. Therefore also that holy thing which shall be born of thee shall be called the Son of God.
Thank you. Luke 2:1-7. And it came to pass in those days that there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And this taxing was first made when Cyrenius was governor of Syria. And all went to be taxed, everyone into his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, unto the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be taxed with Mary, his espoused wife, being great with child. And so it was that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn.
Our next carol is on page 141, The Little Town of Bethlehem.
Thank you. visit Luke 2:8-16. And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping a watch over their flocks by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. You shall find a babe wrapped in swaddling clothes lying in the manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of heavenly hosts praising God and saying, Glory to God in highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward all men. And it came to pass, as the angels were gone away from them into heaven, the shepherds said one to another, Let us now go even unto Bethlehem and see this thing which is come to pass, which the Lord hath made known unto us. And they came with the haste and found Mary and Joseph and babe lying in a manger.
Thank you.
Matthew 2:1-11. Now when Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, in the days of Herod the king, behold, there came wise men from the east to Jerusalem, saying, Where is he that is born, king of the Jews? For we have seen his star in the east, and are come to worship him. When Herod the king had heard these things, he was troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. And when he gathered all the chief priests and scribes of the people together, he demanded of them where Christ should be born. And they said unto him, In Bethlehem of Judea, for thus it is written by the prophet, And thou, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, art not the least among the princes of Judah, but for out of thee shall come a governor that shall rule my people Israel. Then Herod, when he had privily called the wise men, inquired of them diligently what time the star appeared. And he sent them to Bethlehem, and said, Go and search diligently for the young child. And when you have found him, bring me word again, that I may come and worship him also. When they had heard the king, they departed, and lo, the star, which they saw in the east, went before them, till it came and stood over where the young child was. When they saw the star, they rejoiced with great joy. And when they were come into the house, they saw the young child with Mary his mother, and fell down and worshipped him. And when they had opened their treasures, they presented unto him gifts, gold and frankincense and myrrh.
Thank you. Thank you.
appreciate you coming out and spending this evening with us. And we hope that this season, that we celebrate the birth of Christ, that we will remember the reason for the season. And in a few short months, we will celebrate the season of Easter. And the celebration of Christmas is really pointing to the celebration of Easter. Because Jesus was born into the world to become our Savior. And to be our Savior, he had to give his life on Calvary's cross and shed his blood in our stead and take our place. The cross that was his should have been ours. The crown of thorns that he wore on his head should have been our crown of thorns. And the whipping that he took on his back should have been ours. But God in his grace provided Jesus his son. And Christmas is a season of giving. And for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth on him should have eternal life. And so Jesus came to be our Savior. And we need to remember as we celebrate, Christmas is such a happy time. And I know that the children get so excited about Christmas. And I know that the moms and dads get so excited about school starting again in January. But we love to see the children enjoy Christmas time. And we love to see adults enjoy Christmas time. So Christmas is a great time for the young and the young at heart. You never have to be too old to enjoy Christmas. And so this evening, we want to wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. And a prosperous new year. From our house to yours, Merry Christmas and Happy New Year.
Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Ring your bell.